Menudo, you're up at the 195, a new weight class for you. How's it feel at that weight?
I feel great. I mean, sharp, fast, strong, ready to kill.
You've been training with Mo, Mayweather. You've been training with some incredible people like Mayhem. Tell us about some of the great things that you're actually doing at the Reign Training Academy.
It's all good. I was good at training champions, and those guys are really good fighters. And they all give, we share experience, and I make sure that we, get ready sharp for the fight.
So tell us, what's your strategy to fight Lawa?
Whatever it takes to finish the fight before the bell's ringing in, and go for submission, knock him out, whatever it takes.
Tell us, so here you go against Zaroeskis, and what are your plans against how to fight him in this really important fight in front of your new place that you're living now in California?
Yeah, now I train in Brazil for next fight. I train 6 months in Brazil, training hard every day. Zaroeskis, good opponent, champion of the K1 Dreams. I have a lot of respect for my opponent, but I want to win, I need to win, yeah, I win for knockout.
I'm born and raised in San Luis Obispo, 3 hours north of here, and trained at the Pit for 5-6 years, trained at Dokkan Jiu-Jitsu, Japanese place up in Atascadero. California's my home. Joined the Army in 2003. And then,
on a world tour?
Yep, been fighting both professionally in the cage and overseas ever since. And fighting Trevor Prangley this Wednesday night, June 16th on Showtime. I'm going to try to knock somebody out.
Tell us a little bit about your background. In obviously, you came across some great wrestlers from Cal Poly San Luis Obispo wrestling team, the Mustangs. Did you wrestle against Jake Shields when he was there?
Yeah, Jake was actually the guy that brought me to the Pit. He was, I was training at a little Japanese jiu-jitsu place, and I thought it was the man. He's a pretty good wrestler, and Jake comes in and out-wrestled me, and I'm like, who the hell is that guy? So I follow him to the Pit, met Chuck and Scott Lighty and all those guys, and just loved it ever since.
Tell us about your strategy against Trevor.
He's a tough guy. He's a superb wrestler. I think I'm a better striker. I think I'm more technical. I think I'm faster. And, I'm going to outpoint him on the outside. I'm going to outwork him, when I get inside. If we're on the ground, I know my jiu-jitsu's better. So, I'm just going to try to bring it to him the whole fight.
FightCoverage.com here with Conor Ewing, back, badder than ever, coming back from the Legends Gym, the great notorious gym out of Los Angeles, California. Conor, you're ready to go up against KJ News. Tell us about what you think.
I'm excited about the fight. It's a huge opportunity to be able to represent here in front of my hometown, in front of my crowd, in front of the kids at the middle school I coach wrestling at, in front of the students I teach over at Legends MMA. And they've heard me talk the talk about triumph over adversity and never giving up for a long time. But it's time for me to walk the walk, and I'm really proud to be able to do that in front of my students here in LA. And really show him what it means to be a fighter.
Tell us about your strategy against KJ Nunes. He's a great fighter. He's been proven. He's had some tough fights.
My dad always told me, you go to the dance, you dance with who brought you. And I got this fight from, putting on a performance against George Gurgel, showing my heart and tenacity. I had some problems with my footwork in that fight. I was chasing him rather than cutting him off. I wasn't checking the low kick. But I've worked on those things, and I've been building my power and my striking prowess from the ground up. Working that fight with Frankie Lyles, working this fight almost exclusively with Chris Riley, and I'm itching for a knockout.
Awesome. Here we are with Marcus Koval from Sweden, fighting out of LA at 135. It's going to be the new catch weight at 135. 135, guys, he's going to be fighting against an incredible fighter. Marcus, congratulations. Welcome to the world, the international world of mixed martial arts. You have a great opportunity. We know we've seen you training. You're also training with Fabrizio Verdum as well at Combat Academy. You're from Sweden. Tell the rest of the world your fight that's coming up.
I've been training with Fabrizio now for several years with him and Lucas Perez down at Verdum Combat Team, as well as here at Krav Maga Worldwide where we are today. And, my background is in boxing and kickboxing, but I really feel like I picked up my ground game, and I'm here to entertain, this is entertainment, and I trained hard because I want to give the fans what they want. I want to thank Strikeforce for giving the opportunity to fight for them, and I won't disappoint, I promise.